would consider the short story to be baby boomer lit, which was recognized at the end of 2012 as a separate genre. The character, Deborah, is 55, so she's a younger baby boomer. She's already dealing with some of these issues because she's a widow, and she's also concerned about her mother, who's just gone into a nursing home.
In my work, I like repetition. I like for pattern and stuff. And so when I read Elena's short story, I definitely wanted to explore the idea of the breaststroke, how Deborah only did the breaststroke. So I thought that was really telling, and it interested me a lot. And the idea of going up and down the lanes, repeating that pattern over and over again. So that's how the basic imagery came about, was that way. The shape of my book, and the book is kind of a loose description of it, is in a circle form. So I like that idea of repetition, and I imagined when I was doing it that it would be, you could either view it on the wall or walk around it.
Well, I found a real pleasure to work with Heather, and was lucky to get paired with a talented artist that produced some great art. Because my story was already written, and what she was doing was not illustrating it, but taking things from the story that would inspire the art.
So Ellen is wearing a pin that I made out of clay, which is actually printed and then fired in a kiln. So I did a variety of bathing suit pins. So again, that was sort of an inspiration. I read that passage and really liked it and thought, oh, what could I do with that? I did some research and found that there are very few circle books, and now I know why. Especially when you're printing it on a continuous piece of paper, because as you're printing, which can take layers and layers, if you screw up, then you have to start over again. And I did like three times. And it's a big piece of paper. I think it's 52 inches around. It does fold into a book. So it actually does fold. I found that this project really interesting, and the outcome, I mean, having it permanently installed in the library definitely is something to be proud of, like the writers and the artists. So I really appreciate that, and just the different approach I took with this is different than anything I've done before. Like I mentioned that I haven't made artist books before, so it's something that I would think about doing again, for sure.